Look at me standing before you. All Ghanaians, look at me.
How old are you?
I'm 32 years old now.
And how long have you been here?
I've been in prison for 13 years. I came to prison when I was 19 years old.
What brought you into prison?
It was a suspect murder. They suspected me of killing my own grandmother, which is not true.
Did you do it?
I didn't.
Condemned block usually evokes fear in many Ghanaians. I'm here with Superintendent Kavi to lead me to the condemned block. What makes people fear the condemned block so much?
People fear the condemned block simply because it is where people who have been sentenced to death are kept. So because of that, they fear the police.
Right. Let's go inside and then tell us over there. I'm currently at the condemned block of Nsawam Medium Security Prison. And the condemned block usually puts a lot of fear in many Ghanaians because it is perceived that those who come here have no hope. I'm here to talk to some of the leaders to find out some of the problems they go through at this facility. And as you can see, there are some very old and in critical condition, but they have no choice but to be here and face the rigors of prison life. Let's talk to some of them and then find out what they go through on a daily basis. How are you doing?
I'm doing well, but not all that good.
Why not all that good?
As you can see, our situation is not easy to be at this place.
First of all, good afternoon to all Ghanaians who are watching us. We thank you for your time. We are standing here before you as our brothers, mothers, sisters, families, and everything, humbly pleading to you to take part justice with mercy on our behalf. President Nana Akufo-Addo, we really know that you came for all Ghanaians. We are humbly pleading to you. Look at the young boys here who have been sentenced to death. 20 years, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, to 30, 40 years. And some of them are even 70 years old. We are still on death row. And one most painful thing is that when you've been sentenced to death, you are going to spend 10 years on the death row. After that, when amnesty comes, the prison officers will take you to life imprisonment. And then you will spend 20 years for that. After the 20-year sentence, they will give you another 10-year sentence to be served. And as for that, it's not consistent. It can happen that a president will take over or something will take over, and the amnesty we're supposed to become will delay for maybe 2 years or 1 year. Mm. It will cost you maybe 13 or 12 years for condemned block before moving to the main yard, which is life imprisonment. But what did I know in Ghana Constitution is that I'm not a law practitioner. But what I know in Ghana Constitution is that, apart from court, no one can impose sentence on anyone. So you don't understand the reason why. If the government said
those on death row have been pardoned. The prison officers will take here to yard for a life sentence of 20 years. Mm. 10 years. Before the 10 years, they will give you 20 years to serve before you go home.
Mm.
Officer, look at me standing before you. All Ghanaians, look at me.
How old are you?
I'm 32 years old now.
And how long, how long have you been here?
I've been in prison for 13 years. I came to prison when I was 19 years old.
What brought you into prison?
It was a suspect murder. They suspected me of killing my own grandmother, which
did,
is not true.
Did you do it?
I didn't do.
Are you sure?
I'm sure. My you can go to my family right now. The clan head of the family is ready. I didn't do anything.
We have in our presence a very fragile looking old man. He looks sick.
Edene, yo.
We know be in a coin. And more sentence.
No, only Panacuna and Edene see a sentence.
Mini Panacuna, no, Iprano.
Okay.
Or no, dear bar, a bombing, I'm Smithy America. Namedi, Sikani Jabal, or Machi, Nasikani Kana Pampa. When what once more, a dear fate will soon be answered, as I know will be. A Bushan say, Omoyano, Madakis, and a judge in his own to me and a Madakis. Already nobody in Kaji Limi of Wasi. Secret. The judge is on to me, you know, as a madakism. I was also searching now on Yeno Sadia and you be in Abacumas. Amy Becumasino, would jay on Jelly me 4 years, my trade and I'm Jana, Amadi Becumasua.
Okay,
Kumasa won a metra 4 years, it will 2 years, 8 months.
Say, Yahoo said, Ojari. I didn't know that's what happened. Then I'm penny 4 years for a situation.
I'm penny 4 years for me, beer.
And then I
am diabetes.
Diabetes.
If you are copper toilet, I'm a bed 10 months.
Still a hunt.
You are really coming 2:13.
Okay. Let's. So as you heard him, he's been here for a very long time, but currently he is suffering from diabetes. We would want to find out how the authorities treat people like this who are in dire situations. Let's talk to Superintendent Kavi to find out how the prison authorities respond to such situations. Superintendent, what usually happens when you have people like this at the condemned block?
Oh, to have people like this at the condemned block, when we see that their condition is not that bad, we take them to our infirmary or health center facility in the prison yard. But if it's at Belfast, we refer them to in some government hospital, Kolegu or police hospital or any other facility.
Are you waiting for something to happen before you take further action?
Oh, he has been to in some government hospital several times. And anytime he goes there, they will bring him back. So we as prison authorities, laymen, they have this thing. We can't say anything. It is the medical doctors who can recommend that his health is deteriorating.
Mm. So right. And then now, oh, hi, then now, you see.
Yes, it's toilet. I give me the only come on. We have from Benin, my toilet is a Cecilia, no pay, Coca Cramming, my toilet for 5 minutes. Yeah, I didn't.
So, as you heard him, his situation is so precarious that anytime he eats, he has to visit the toilet. And his situation continues to get worse and worse.